Radio.
Hey everybody, it's Shamika
and Alicia coming to you every Wednesday right through your speaker.
So log in or stream live
and give both of us that viral high five.
Cause when you tune in, you'll never know
what you may learn
on the Hey Shamika Show. And it's Hey Shamika with comedian Alicia Coley. It is Wednesday, y'all. Happy hump day, everyone. Hope y'all are having a great day. Man, oh man, has it been a week? You know, it was holiday week this week, so that means lots of people cooked out. Lots of people had the day off. I know not everyone did, so. But those of you that had the day off, I hope y'all enjoyed it, especially those of us that have gone back to school. Of course, here in Georgia, we have. And that three-day weekend, thank you. Thank you, Jesus. It was wonderful. But anyway, this is Shamika, of course. Miss Alicia will be here in any moment. And we have a great fun show for you guys this week. We have, for the first time, we have a couple of adolescents that will be on the show. Amaya Coley, which is also Alicia's daughter. She sings, she raps, she dances. I think she does a little acting as well. She's going to be in the studio tonight. And we'll also have Keon Knight, also aka DJ Caution, will be in the studio as well. And then we also have a special guest, Karen Kennedy. She's a comedian, she's an author, she's an educator. She will also be here in the studio a little bit later on. So I hope everyone is tuning in. Everyone's had a great week. Nothing much been going on too much with me this week. I had a great weekend. I actually went to Lynchburg, Virginia. Went to visit my uncle. He actually had brain surgery, so you know that was pretty serious, but he is doing well. And other than that, not too much been going on. Oh, and here's Miss Alicia that's coming in. And Miss Amaya, hi ladies. How are y'all? Good. Oh, look at your hair looking all cute. Oh, I need to do that too. You did that, Alicia?
Yes, I did. I be doing stuff.
Let me find out. Let me find out. I'm about to come to you and get my hair did.
Yeah. I do a little something, something. You know how you got to do when you got kids. You got to make stuff happen.
That's right.
Even if you look a wreck.
I just been saying hello to everybody.
Hey, y'all.
Just kind of talking about it. It was a nice three-day weekend, you know, holiday weekend for most people.
Oh, yeah, for most people. I had my little holiday. Well, actually, I worked because we're on this big project that I've been telling you about. And I worked for about 4 hours. So I had a half a day. And I don't like that. I don't like working on my day off.
You always working.
I'm always working. When I'm off, when I'm on, when I'm asleep, I be working.
And, you know, I figured out that I'm always working, too. Sometimes I be trying to tell myself I'm not working. You know how you try to trick yourself, be like, oh, I ain't going to do no work today.
Right.
And next thing you know, you be like, man.
Let me send a couple text messages. See if these niggas listen.
Look, some texts, you know, follow up on some emails.
Right.
No, I'd be like, dang, that's work, that's work.
I know how it go.
Yeah.
I know how it go.
Miss Amaya, how are you doing today?
I'm good.
You're good? How was school?
Amazing.
What? Amazing?
That's what she be saying.
Honey, I need to go to your school. It's amazing. Dang.
No, I ain't trying to do that again. They were like, spell cat. I was like, you know what? He left.
Yeah, I done put in my time with the school at least for a little bit.
Mm-hmm.
I'm probably going to go back again, though. You know, have to up on the, do my
re-up bachelor's on the knowledge.
Yeah, the bachelor's in nursing and master's in nursing. You know, got to get that in so
sounds
I can be
so
a family nurse practitioner. You know,
can you write prescriptions with that?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, because I'm going to tell you what I need.
You know, that's what everybody waiting on. My family like, so when you say you going back?
When you going to write them scriptures?
I'm like, you know, I'm not going back just quite yet, you know. But at least they have programs online now. You know, I can do it in 2 years, so.
And 2 years ain't bad because you know how fast 2 years fly? Like she was just three not too long ago. Like, it's crazy. That's how fast they be flying by. Like, you just skip over the 2 years. I see how I did that. Y'all didn't even realize
girl,
how I did that.
Yep. All right, guys. Well, of course, you know, this is the Hey Shamika Show with comedian
Alicia Coley.
And we will be right back with y'all.
Yes, we will. We good.
Hey, what's up, everybody? It's your girl, comedian Alicia Coley, and you're listening to the Hey Shamika Show with me. Tune in and stay locked in every Wednesday from 7 to 9 p.m. Join us, laugh with us, and learn with us. Y'all gotta come on. Stay locked in.
And we are back with the Hey Shamika Show with comedian
Alicia Coley.
And I think are we on sauce already?
I think we might be on sauce.
Yeah, we already on sauce.
Even if we ain't on sauce, we on sauce. And y'all know what sauce means.
Yep. That's Shamika and Alicia's unfiltered commentary. Now, it may be just a little filtered this week, just a little bit, you know. Because
we got babies in here.
Yeah, we got a little underage folks in the house, but that's all right, though. We know how to talk.
Yeah.
To children. I work with kids every day, and you've been a mom a long time, so you know how to do it.
Yep. So I basically wanted to talk about some of the trending things that's going on right now, especially the Nike.
I knew we were coming with the Nike.
issue.
Right. That's on top of the list.
Because I just don't feel like, this is the thing. So I've been hearing a little bit of everything, but I'm not, so you can correct me if you heard some other stuff, or y'all could correct me too, whoever tunes in live, or, you know, y'all could call in. But Colin Kaepernick has been kneeling for injustice.
Right.
So I heard that Nike had always had this check for him. Mm-hmm. You know, I didn't know that part. So they waited to their 30th anniversary to make him, I guess, the spokesperson or whatever the thing is for Nike. Mm-hmm. And people are mad. But it's still the same thing. It's like, why are y'all so mad about this man getting a check? How was he supposed to survive?
They don't care about that part, child. They do not care. To them, to the people that's upset, you know, because I'm not upset.
Right.
I'm overjoyed about it. Right. But to those that are upset, they seem to be upset because they feel that he's not being patriotic. You know, that somehow he's, you know, going against being, you know, American, you know, going against the, you know, the Star Spangled Banner, all that good stuff. So to them, they feel that if he's getting paid for it, then he's not, quote unquote, learned his lesson.
But isn't he black and white, though?
Yes.
Okay, so he fighting for on both sides. Like, are you serious, sir? Ma'am? Whoever it is?
Well, my thing is, this is the problem with America right now. They have to turn everything into a race issue. Now, the reason what he's doing for the injustice, yes,
right,
that is a racial issue. And also, there has been, I know a lot of people have brought into and talked about it, there has a lot of been injustice with the police that's been for different races, not just not just blacks now.
Right.
We're talking about, you know, Spanish people, white people. It's been injustice all the way around.
It has
been.
And
to me, him kneeling stood for all of that. He didn't specifically say that was that. So it was for all.
It was for all. And they're losing the message on purpose. And that's what I hate about racism and things that go against one race. Because if he's fighting for the injustice, which he said, period. But we know that a lot of those injustices are brought about black Americans, you know, or American men. A lot of times we're the ones, we're the race that gets the most hype on those issues. So they're trying to make it seem like you said, it was just about one race when it really wasn't.
Right.
But I want to talk about how Nephew Tommy talked about today. He said,
okay, I missed that part.
He just said, he always makes a profound statement like once a month, or, you know, every so often he'll make a profound statement when he says he keeps telling y'all what he's kneeling for and what he's fighting for, but y'all keep on trying to change it like it's against the flag.
Exactly. Right.
And I thought about that, I think, but I'm not sure that I kind of really grasp it until this morning when he said that. And I'm like, he's right. This
he
dude
said
never,
over and over.
Right. He never said it was about anything else before the injustice.
He never said he was unpatriotic. He never said he wasn't, you know, American. He never said he was against,
exactly,
you know, the Star Spangled Banner, the national anthem. Never said any of that.
So now
he
people
just said,
wanna,
I'm simply
kneeling
because of
the
A,
injustice.
B, and C.
Yes. And now people burning their Nikes.
Honey.
Y'all had to burn them. Y'all 7.5. My daughter wears, which house you wear? 6.5? If y'all want to, if y'all got some new Nikes.
I can wear 7, 7.5, you know, 8, depending on how I'm made. I can get it done.
I'm telling y'all, I ain't no stranger to hand-me-downs. I take them.
Now, speaking of them burning stuff, they were also saying that people were cutting the swooshes off of stuff. Guys, it's still Nike.
It's still Nike.
It's still Nike.
It's still Nike. And, I don't care if your swoosh is going or not. If the swoosh was there at one time, the swoosh is still swooshed in your mental.
And I'm not sure how many people or who started this, but I know they were saying, if you're going to destroy this stuff, why not just give it away to the homeless, give it away to veterans?
Right.
You know, stuff that people say they concerned about.
Yes.
They care about these social issues, but you willing to burn some stuff before you give it away to somebody. That shows you how, to me, that shows you when people are being irrational.
Yes.
These
ludicrous.
Are irrational thoughts, because nobody's sitting around just burning clothes for no reason.
Right. I need all my clothes.
Give it to somebody.
I need all my clothes.
You know, all the homeless, all the veterans, all the children that are in school right now that need shoes.
That need shoes.
Honey.
Just being rude and ignorant.
That's my vote, everybody. If you don't want Nike no more, please send them to your local school.
There you go.
Wherever your school is, send your shoes to that, and I promise you that school will make sure they go to good use, go to children that need them. So that's my part on that. Mm-hmm. Please, please, guys, if you listen, if you don't want them, send them to your local school. We will gladly take them.
And instead of a check, I'm going to give you a swoosh.
Love it. Love it.
Yep. And then another thing that happened since we were gone, Aretha Franklin's funeral happened.
Yes.
Fantasia tore it down.
Okay. Yeah, what? She tore it. All right.
What you going to say?
Lord knows I love Aretha. That was the longest funeral. And that got to be in the Guinness books.
Yo, so many memes. It was ridiculous about this funeral.
Now, I was at my at the hospital. Mm-hmm. You know, I missed most of it. But then we started watching on the TV.
Right.
And then when we got home from the hospital, it was still on. I said, now, wait a minute.
And if you was at a hospital, you know hospital visits be long. Yeah, so if you went to the hospital and came back, that was a long funeral.
I said, now, wait a minute. I know this funeral's still on. I said, maybe this is a replay. But it kept saying live up at the top. I said, now, you know, they had to have intermissions now for breakfast, lunch, and dinner.
I think people just excused themselves out, and they had this food sitting on the side waiting for people because they knew they was going to be hungry.
They had to. That didn't make any sense.
Right.
Now, they had this funeral. You know how we grow up. You got, you know, got the repast. If y'all had that long a funeral, what they do with the repast?
Child, they just went home. It wasn't no repast. It was come as you are, go eat when you can, come back, sit down, enjoy the concert, then go home. It's over. Ain't no repast. Yeah. It's over.
Yeah. I mean, but a lot of the people that I did get to hear speak did say a lot of great things about her, had a lot of great stories about her growing up. The only other thing I really did not care for, and I know they've done this a lot when it comes to someone that's been in the public eye a long time, and I know the reasoning behind it, but when they kind of make it a political thing,
what
they kind of want to talk about different social things. They were just talking about, you know, people turning out for voting, you know, different political stances, a couple of people, more than a couple, kind of say something, and I know the purpose behind that is they know so many people are watching. So that's their opportunity to get it out there because they know a lot of these people don't watch the news. A lot of these people don't do anything that has to do with that. So I know I get it. Mm-hmm. But I still think that is not the proper time to do that.
I agree with that.
Like, do that at an award show. There's plenty of award shows happening.
True.
In the next few weeks. And that's just happened. Do that on an award show, guys.
I agree.
That is somebody's funeral.
That's a little disrespectful because, to me. Yeah, we should always try and not bring any of your political views onto something that's like that.
Right.
Like, and I was going to say, even, remember we kept talking about the Molly Tibbetts death, the girl that was running, and she was in Brooklyn, Iowa. I thought she was in Brooklyn, New York, but it was Brooklyn, Iowa. And she turned up missing, and they actually found her body. Mm. And when she was killed, it was a Mexican guy who had been working under a fake name. Then, of course, your president talking about some, see, this is why get them out of here.
Their president.
Their president.
Come on. Don't do it.
That's why we got to get them out of here because those bad hombres or whatever, you know. So he tried to use that as a political stance as well to say, see, this is why what I'm talking about. So vote for me because I'm smart. No, you're still dumb. You're still dumb, and that one incident is not going to get this off on us. Like, sir, stop.
I think they would officially shut down his Twitter if it wasn't so funny to so many people.
Right.
That people actually got pure entertainment out of it. Mm-hmm. I think they would just shut it down all the way.
Right. So what you think about your president? You got to speak into the microphone now. Yeah.
Yes, Ms. Amaya, come on.
What you think about your president?
I don't like him.
Why?
I don't like him because it's just, he didn't do much about
He don't do anything? Us. He don't do anything you like?
No.
Okay, I understand.
Yeah. I know a lot of people were saying that it's profound to see that, you know, also, you know, when you talk about passing, you know, Senator John McCain.
Right.
You know. God rest him as well, that passed away. A lot of people were saying that how he made sure to say he didn't want him to to come to the funeral. That's pretty bad.
That's pretty bad.
And that's you the say second specifically, person. Right. You say specifically.
Right.
You don't want them at your funeral. Knowing you ain't even going to be there.
Knowing you ain't even going to be there.
You don't even care, but you don't want them there.
This one person could just throw the whole energy off at a funeral where it ain't supposed to be no real energy like that anyway.
Right. But I thought it was nice that he wanted, you know, President Obama and President George W.
Yep.
To, you know, do eulogies at his funeral.
And then I think, you know what, I want to talk about this at Frankly Friends, too, but I want to say at this segment, but just look at how the Obamas get along with George Bush. You know what I'm saying? So just because you're a different political party doesn't mean you have to be enemies. Doesn't mean you have to create such hate for each other. You can always have a difference of opinion. You know, that doesn't mean that you're that you have to agree or that you're necessarily wrong or right, but you have your difference of opinion and you respect it and you'll move on. And you agree to disagree. You're like, you know what? That color is yellow. No, it's not. It's canary. No, it's not. It's yellow. Okay, you go with canary. I'm going to go with yellow. All right, we cool? All right, let's go eat. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, I have always told people now, I didn't care for him as a president because I don't think he really did the role he was supposed to do as president when George W. was in office, but I love him as a person.
Right.
He is a good-hearted person. He's a great humanitarian.
Right.
And I think so too. That has done a lot of things, and he's actually a great artist. A lot of people don't know that part about him.
He's a great who?
Artist.
Artist. Mm-hmm. Oh, okay.
Yep, he's a great artist as well, but people just don't see that part of him. The problem with politics is people attach what happens when someone's in office as a president or a senator or whatever.
Right.
Who they have attached to them as a person.
Mm-hmm.
No, that's just what happened when they were in office. I hate to say it like this, but it's a job.
It is.
Like any other jobs. And if you're in a job and you leave that job, some of us carry a little bit of that with you, but it seems like they carry that for the rest of their life.
That is
they
true.
They cannot get away with that. People talk about it over and over and over.
Well, the most profound thing that I remember about his candidacy is the shoe throwing. I can't really remember anything that he really necessarily did, but that ducking that shoe, he did that. I said, okay. He moved like he was...
He got on the Matrix.
Dodging bullets, yes. I was like, okay.
They was training them.
They was training them.
Secret Service was doing their job, boy.
Yes.
All right, guys. That's already the end of Frankly Friends Sauce for this week. But I'm sure we'll definitely be, like she said, talk a little bit more
about
the friendship part in Frankly Friends. So we will be right back with the Hey Shamika Show with comedian
Alicia Coley.
When we wake up and then we feel so nice. You're my water when I'm stuck in the desert. You're the talent all I take when my head hurts. You're the sunshine of my life. I just wanna see how beautiful you are. You know that I see it. I know you're a star. Where you go, I'll follow. No matter how far. If life is a movie, then you're the best part. If you love me, won't you say something? If you love me, won't you? Love me, won't you? If you love me, won't you say something? If you love me, won't you? If you love me, won't you say something? If you love me, won't you? Love me, won't you? If you love me, won't you say something? If you love me, won't you? If you love me, won't you say something?
Hey y'all, this is Shamika Love. Tune in and stay locked in to the Hey Shamika Show with comedian Alicia Coley here on IBNXRadio.com.
And we are back with Hey Shamika with comedian
Alicia Coley in the building.
And we have one Amaya.
We have Amaya Coley in the building today.
Hello, hello.
Look at her. So Amaya, how you doing today?
I'm great.
You're great. Okay. Did you go to school today?
Yes, I did.
And did you have a good day in school?
Yes.
You passing your classes?
Yes.
Better be. You don't pass them classes. You know what happens to them.
Now, for everybody that's listening and watching, like mother, like daughter, Miss Amaya is Alicia's daughter, and yes, she's a singer, rapper, dancer. She do a little acting too, don't she?
She do a little bit of everything.
All right, multifaceted, love it, love it.
Yeah, she does a little bit of everything. So, Maya, why don't you tell the people how long you've been singing?
I've been singing for about 7 years now.
Almost your entire life. Look at you. Talk about almost 7 years.
Yes. So she's been singing about 7 years, she says. And I asked her today, I said, well, since you've been singing for 7 years, what's your favorite song? And she will talk about some Respect by Aretha.
Now, what's not wrong with that being her favorite song now?
At three.
Listen. That's a great song.
It is.
That's a great song. So tell me what kind of songs you were singing, you know, in the beginning, since you've been singing for 7 years. What's your favorite type of songs? Like R&B, hip-hop, you know, old school? What you like?
A mixture of everything.
Okay, I like that. Of course, she look just like your mama.
No, she don't. She look like her dad.
I said just like your mama. Oh, and I know she look like dog.
Oh, you mean the look that she get? Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah. So, Amaya is an aspiring singer, slash dancer, slash more aspiring to sing. I noticed that she had a voice, and so I said, let me see if I can make some money off this voice, because kids get expensive, and honey. I said, let me try to figure it out. So we've been doing some vocal training for her. So how you liking vocal training?
It's awesome, actually.
Okay, you got more than one word you want to describe stuff with? I mean, my goodness. Everything is great. It's awesome.
Yeah, it's that age group. But that's okay. Doing stuff like this will help, you know, help you get started for these interviews, because they're going to be coming. You got to get ready. That's all right.
So who's your favorite artist?
Favorite artist, I would have to say Beyonce.
Okay.
Hey, everybody pick Beyonce?
Because she's
not
the queen.
Everybody. Not everybody.
Well, who are your favorite artists?
Oh, I have a lot of favorites.
She about to say Beyonce too?
No. Actually, Whitney Houston, Celine Dion.
Okay.
Are two of my favorites. I have a lot, but those are two of my top favorites.
Okay.
Women.
Right. Yeah. Okay, so Mel.
Mel, I would have to say Gerald Levert and Luther Vandross.
You going big old school.
At the top. I have a lot of favorites, but when I stand out and think of stuff that I've listened to as a child and through adulthood, those are them.
You got a favorite male singer?
That's hard. But the top two is Shawn Mendes and Justin Bieber.
Okay. I know Justin Bieber. I didn't know that first one you said.
Shawn Mendes. What does he sing again?
What's something?
Stitches.
Oh, okay. Yeah.
He was one of the brothers. Wasn't he a brother or somebody? Who was them brothers that broke up and got back together? Wasn't it somebody? The brothers group that was just together not too long ago. It was like four of them.
I don't know.
Okay, well then never mind.
I was gonna say, you know, I came up with the boy band group, so you had New Edition, you had what's that, Backstreet Boys,
Menudo.
NSYNC. She said Menudo.
Yeah, Menudo.
And that's all my New Kids on the Block.
New Kids on the Block, yes. Girl. Yeah. You know. I gotta tell her about these groups because I don't think we gotta go over to them groups and YouTube them old school boy bands from back in the day.
When I'm traveling on the highway, like when I was traveling this past weekend, you know, I listen to some of the older albums because that's good traveling music.
I guess so.
You know, because they have some, you know, kind of stuff, got a little hip hop,
like,
little beats to it, and then they got some, you know, slow ballad songs. So.
Mm-hmm.
Back in the day. I don't care what nobody say, I still like R. Kelly songs. Sorry, y'all.
Yeah. We're going to slide right past that R. Kelly guy and Amaya. So, back to you. So, if you could meet your favorite artist, like, if let's say we had the power to bring your favorite artist, like, right in this building, like, right now, who would you say would be on the other side of that door, favorite artist?
Ooh. Queen Naija.
Okay.
Okay.
And she sings that medicine song.
Medicine, Karma, Butterflies, all that.
Oh, okay. Well, what's your favorite song?
Favorite song from her is probably Karma.
Okay. Give us a little Karma. Could you give us a little Karma? A little bit.
I held you down.
Wait. Don't before you do that. Take a breath, think about it. Go ahead and take a and then go ahead into it. So we're going to give her, go ahead.
Go ahead.
Okay, go ahead. I'm sorry. I stopped you. I'm sorry. Go ahead. I just want you to be prepared. It's people watching.
I held you down for the longest, and I was with you all your darkest moments. It was like yesterday when we were homeless. Got you some bread and start treating me bongos.
Okay.
All right, Amaya.
Show the people about the Beyonce song real quick. Just to give them a little bit. Just a little line.
Yeah, give us a little bay.
I am in love with you. You set me free. I can't do this thing called life without you here with me.
All right, that's enough. Everything goes right.
Yes. Yes. Love it.
Good. You did good.
I like that we have some younger people on the show today because I like to see the talent.
What the youth are up to.
Yes, is the talent. It's so many talented kids.
Yes.
So
yes,
many. And shout out to the parents that see that talent, that see that talent and are doing their best to help foster that talent and help them get to the next level with it.
Right.
Kudos to all you guys, Alicia and Dolphin.
Kudos to the parents. That's right.
Now, Miss Amaya, let's talk a little bit about the dance now. Now, how long have you been dancing?
Since I was 3 too.
All right, so you just been doing it all since you was 3.
I guess so.
Okay, now what's your favorite type of dance, would you say?
Hit them folks.
The hit them folks dance, so hip-hop dancing?
Yeah. Okay, hip-hop dancing. Hip-hop. Now, do you do a little bit? Like, have you done, like, jazz classes or tap dance and stuff like that?
Tap dancing, I did that when I was little.
Oh, look at her face. I did that when I was little.
So on the tap dancing and the dance classes and stuff like that, this was the only kid that I know that actually said, I don't want to do this. You know what I'm saying? Like a lot of kids, they be wanting to do classes. Well, you know what? My son did the same thing when I tried to put him on the choir. He was like, leave that to them other kids. I ain't trying to sing. I was like, dude, like, how do you know that? And he's actually a good singer. Like, he can hold the note. Mm-hmm. So I was pretty surprised when he said that. But Amaya is my how you do this dance kid. Where gotcha. My son, he's not the how you do this dance. My son is the more so how you program this whatever electronic device, you know. Right. So they have, both of them have their own separate gifts, which I'm very proud of, and I try to hone in and make sure that they are getting what they need for both of what they need or both of what they do or interested in. So that's what you know, I try to make sure of
that.
There's
nothing wrong with saying that you don't want to do that. Yeah. Because to me, that's better than you wasting effort, absolutely, time, and money.
The big M.
You know, now I believe all kids have some type of activity, you know, and sometimes it takes two or three times for people to figure out, and for kids definitely, to figure out if that's their passion, if that's something they really like that they want to continue doing. Luckily, you figured that out at 3 years old. Mm-hmm. You done saved your parents a lot of money.
Yeah.
I know they really happy about that.
I was happy about it, but I just wanted to see her do a little bit more or whatever, you know, as far as that, because, like, I was in all classes. And I know parents shouldn't push their beliefs on their kids about the way they should go or like that, but you really should guide your children.
Right.
So, you know, I just felt like, well, shoot, I was in tap dance. I was in jazz class. I was in ballet class. What's wrong with my child? Why is she not doing all of this that I used to do? Why she don't want to do it? She should want to do this. So I just, you know, wanted that for her. But that's not what she wants to do. And I think kids nowadays, they're a lot smarter than we were. Like, they, back in the day, like, and I'm saying that, no, I'm saying it like, they know what they want instead of, and they're more vocal.
Okay.
You know, when I say that. Mm-hmm. They're more vocal, whereas though, we'll be like, okay, mom. Yeah, you right.
Yeah, because I'm gonna do this, and then, like, halfway through, you be like,
yeah.
This ain't quite what I like to do.
And is our parents really made us do it, too.
Is there something else that I can do? Like, if you were bold enough, you asked if there was something else that you could do.
Right.
You'd be like, listen, especially if you don't put a year into it. And, you know, a lot of times at that point, parents could kind of start telling that it's really not what you wanted to do.
Right.
And then they'd be like, okay, let's pick something else. Because then it's about the money. They don't want to waste the money.
Exactly.
And don't you don't really want to do it.
Don't want to waste the money.
Okay. So, Miss Amaya, speaking of school, do you go to a performing arts school?
Yes.
Okay. So what activities are you in at school? Do you do, like, choir? Are you in band, chorus, any of that?
Okay, so I'm about to do solo singers.
Okay.
And if I don't make that, then I'll just do chorus. So it's kind of a win-win on that.
Now, you know, we got to speak into existence now. When you do become solo singer. Come on now, you got that voice on you.
And she goes to Gwinnett School of Music too. So she does that on the side. So we really are hitting this vocal stuff.
Full steam.
Yes, full steam ahead. She did her first open mic last Wednesday. That's why I wasn't here.
Okay.
So I couldn't miss that, and I couldn't send her by herself. So she did really well on that. We'll post the video.
We'll
post the video later. Okay. I just want to make sure that.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
Yeah, I want to make sure that we get the proper snippet of the video, but she really did a good job, and so we'll continue to do those open mics so she can get more and more comfortable being in front of people and all of that kind of thing.
Don't worry, I gotta do the same thing, and trust me, I'm almost 40. And no matter what age you are, if you're getting into something and it's something that you're starting to do in the public, open mics are where it's at.
Yes, you have to do those open mics.
Yes,
you have to. Yep.
Well, Miss Amaya's going to be here with us the entire show, so we're definitely going to get her, you know, feedback and point of view on a few different topics here and there throughout the show. But we appreciate you having here. Hopefully you're having fun. You've been with us before, but kind of behind the scenes.
Yep.
But we're glad you're here on the mic with us tonight, all right?
Thank you. Thank you for inviting me.
Oh, mm-hmm. You're welcome. Maybe we get you sang a little bit more later on.
Okay.
We're talking Southern today. All right, and this is Hey Shamika with
comedian Alicia Coley, and we will be right back.
She see money all around me. I look like I'm the man. Yeah, but I was clowning out like last week. Tell me, where have you been? Yeah, you came out of hiding, girl. Don't act like I'm your man. I'm just a fan.
With a sick mouth and a slick flow. Got you around me, nigga, ain't a plan. When I'm coming for the kitty, got my full goddamn. Do it for my niggas and the ghost right there. Do it for my niggas and the ghost right now. Niggas got killed for the boy, living dreams in the hills, and they watching for the boy right now. Goddamn, what a time, what a year. We are what them young boys feel. I kill, never be killed, that's real, no lie. You can tell that from my peers right now. Don't you wanna f*** me now? Don't you wanna love me down? Girl, you can't tie me down like Ray J said, but no, I'm down. Freaky nigga, show me something. Shake it like you owe me something. Pushing on the like a button. More time, fifth time, you gush. Still getting rowdy in a function. Just on my like it's nothing. Everywhere I go now, always got bumping, jumping, jumping, jumping.
Hey, nice to meet. I'm Young LA, who you be? Young Southeast and Southeast. Got her clapping to this beat. She invite me to her crib. I walk in, she say my heat. She said, but I live in the hills. That's just the way I sleep. Stop that madness, I'm a savage. In traffic with Mac 11s. Bad and she's Spanish. I fired a girl of vessels. We get nasty, I'm her daddy. She know a nigga ain't average. Ain't nothing wrong with fake bitches. Turn around, let's make magic. I'm geeking, I'm on it. Don't look at me like you want it. Tell them that we ain't stunting it. Fourth down, we ain't punting it. King of District Columbia, can't come here without a permit. This really a jungle, got riches and a condom.
There's some money all around me.
Back with the Hey Shamika Show with comedian Alicia Coley. And right now we are at the segment where we talk about friendships. This is the Frankly Friends segment. And we're not so bent set on how do you friend or what are you doing as a friend right now at this particular moment. Even though we do want to know that, like, you know, if you want to let us, if you want to tell us. But I really wanted to go back to what we was talking about earlier, because people think that because you have different beliefs and because you have a different thought process that you can't be a friend. Like, and I feel like it was just displayed so heavily. It made such a, for me, it made like a good point on at the funeral. Was that the funeral? Yeah, at the funeral, the John McCain funeral, when Michelle and Barack and the Bushes were sitting next to each other and you saw them sharing candy. And I was like, this is such a profound statement. You know, even though two parties don't agree, you know, on their political party,
right,
you know, they can still sit here, hold conversations and respect one another. And they probably went out to eat afterwards. Yeah.
They are actually friends.
Yeah.
Like, as a couple, you know, they're friends as both women are friends, both guys are friends, and they're actually cross friends. Like, you know, I always see,
Michelle Obama and George W.
Yeah.
Always kind of sitting next to each other, chocolate, you know, holding hands and stuff.
Yeah.
And he just, they always say he got a crush on her. He, you know, probably that, right?
Do. He probably do.
She, you know, he be kind of grinning. You know,
you know, white men really love black women. You know they do. I don't know why they don't deny. They keep denying it. I don't know why. They be loving us.
Yeah.
Y'all do.
But for years, actually, they've shown them in that type of light at different events. Unfortunately, funerals.
Yeah.
That they have televised, but some other stuff that they've done as well for past political people that they've always showed them in that light,
right,
that they always have. And it's always when you know they're not thinking anybody's watching them. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
You know how sometimes people, you'd be like, oh, they just doing that because people watch them. No, they're generally that way.
They're generally good people. You know what I'm saying? And there's nothing wrong with being a good person. So many times we harp on the negative and we think that being negative is cool. And
it's not.
It's not cool.
It's not.
It's not cool. How you making out with your friends at school?
Yeah, we're all good.
We're all good.
You're all good.
What does that mean exactly?
Okay, now what grade are you in?
Fifth.
Okay, so you're in the fifth grade, so you probably have some friends that you've been friends with for a few years now, right?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, now, is there anybody new in your grade, new in your class to the school this year that you have befriended?
No.
You know, I thought you became friends with the new grade.
You don't have anybody new there, or you just haven't become friends with them yet? I know it's still early.
I don't really like them.
Don't say that.
You don't really like them. Now, wait a minute.
I don't know. You
what you mean you don't like them? What's going on that you don't like them? This fifth grade now. Let me hear this.
They're just immature. One is immature and one is quiet.
Oh, so new people are immature and quiet. And so you don't necessarily not like them. You just don't like the fact that they don't
how they act.
Or how they act.
Okay. I can respect that now. Immaturity.
Yes.
Yeah, that kind
of gets a lot of immature adults. And that's why we in Frankly Friends segment talking about how immature they are right now, because there's a lot of people that's over 35 that don't know how to act. Matter of fact, I'm going to take that number back a little bit. It's a lot of people under 35 and above 21 that still be acting stupid.
I have run into this issue, and I know you have too. I have a lot of people that seem to be stuck in their mind still in high school.
Right.
Like they still have the same attitude. They treat problems or disagreements. I'm going to call it disagreements because it's really not problems when you're an adult.
Mm-hmm.
Disagreements between friends like you would in high school.
Right.
Guys, stop.
Stop it.
Doing that.
Talk it out.
Right. Talk it out, but they don't want to talk to you no more. And then they upset with you and you have mutual friends. They don't want them friends to talk to you.
Right.
Guys, look, come on now.
And don't text me. You got a problem with me? I'm going to tell you right now. If you got a problem with me, don't text me. If you won't call me to solve this problem, I don't want to talk about it.
Right.
Because if it's important enough for you to text because you're bothered, then you need to call.
Right, call
so I can talk. And I'd rather, you know, I like looking people in their eyes, too. Because they do say the eyes are the mirror to the soul, but I want to see your soul when you come in here with this dumb stuff. Like, what are you telling me? Or even if I'm in the wrong.
Right.
I still want to know where you're coming from with it, you know?
And a lot of times it's either misunderstanding a lot of times, or that person generally, like if you said something, let's per se.
Mm-hmm.
Let's say I said something to someone, they didn't like the way I said it. I might not have heard the way I said it.
Right.
But then, you know, came back.
Even though you said it.
Right, even though I said it. And case in point, I'm going to say this on air because, you know, we friends. So I said something to you before. And even I said something to you before, now even though I sat there and thought about it, and the more I thought about it, because it was through text message, and the more I thought about it, I was like, I don't think that
you
really.
You know what's so funny?
I was like, I
know
think,
what you're talking about, but don't remember the words at all.
Right. I was like, I don't think that really sounded the way I was trying to say. And so I thought about it. I was like, you know what? She may not think it's nothing, but, you know, to me, let me say something. Be like,
but
listen,
sure
I didn't mean.
Ain't.
Right. I was like, you know. I hope you ain't take it that way. That's not the way I meant it.
Right.
And you like, no, I ain't thinking about it. You know, whatever. And I was like, okay, you know, cool. But I'm like, you know, I do that because I know had that been me, I would have been, might have been like,
no. And see, and like, that's
being,
grown.
Like,
that's a grown person.
Or like, what was going on with that?
Right.
You know, so guys, it's nothing wrong with, you know, backtracking and thinking like, you know, I'm not sure. So you just talk about, you ask questions because sometimes the way you say something is not all the way always how someone perceives it. And how you perceive something is always changed also by your immediate environment at the time. People never understand that. Everybody has their own things that they're going through.
That's true.
You know, they could be a little extra stressed that day, you know, thinking about something else. And so what you might say like that on another day could be fly okay, but that day, you know, it kind of hurt them.
Right.
You know, a little bit. So, and I'm a type of person, I don't ever want to hurt anybody's feelings. Right. Now, I know I have before, because I was being a little mean. But even in those situations, and I know I'm being wrong, like, I'll calm down, and I'll go back to the person afterwards and say, listen.
Right.
I apologize for the way it came out.
Right.
You know, but I meant.
I meant what I said.
I meant what I said, but I didn't mean it to sound like
as
that.
As harsh.
Right. So, right. A lot of times, that's why I don't even say anything while I'm upset. And mad because I know it's not gonna come out right.
Right.
I have a smart mouth.
Yeah, you do got a pretty smart mouth. Yeah. I mean, a lot of people do, but you know.
Yeah, but so I try to be cognizant of that fact, and not pass that along to people because I want people to feel comfortable, you know, coming to me and talk to me about anything. And to me, you cannot do that if you feel someone is being judgmental first, or if you feel like they don't value. Your thoughts, value, you know, value your emotions, your feelings.
Right. No,
so,
I agree.
So that's my thing. And I think a lot of times that's why people still friends with me. Because at the end of the day, you know, they know they can talk to me about something. I'm not going to judge you about
it.
Because I don't like people judging me, so I don't judge other people. I let them say what their thing. And I have a habit, and my brother, that's why he calls me. I let him say his thing, and I go, okay, I understand where you're coming from. And I try to give him the other side.
Right.
Well, maybe... Mm-hmm. You know, da da da. He'd be like, "Oh, okay, well, I can maybe, you know, see that, give another side of it." Because sometimes we're not able to see another side, especially if you're in the emotion,
right,
at the time,
right. So, Amaya, how you handle conflict at in fifth grade? How do you handle things when stuff gets a little crazy between you and your friends, and somebody might not like the other person, or somebody you might not like the other person, or you know, but you've already been friends with them, or how do you handle that? Do you go to the person and say, you know what, I was wrong, I'm sorry, you were acting silly, so this is why you made me act this way. So what do you do
and to
resolve conflict?
Mostly, I would go up to the person and tell them what they did wrong, and then if they did something wrong, and then I did something wrong, and it was a whole mistake. Then I would talk to them about it, and then we would figure things out.
I think that's very mature of
you. Look, she's very mature. Look, that's your daughter.
That, yeah.
That is your daughter.
Because she know I ain't with the BS. She know I'm not with the BS.
We'll
like it's and that trickles down to your children, because if you got a petty mom, you going to have petty kids. So that's just how it is.
That is the truth, because my mama, honey, this is why I got the smart mouth. I'm going to be honest. My mama, some days.
See, but I think your mom, and I know, listen, my mom got a smart mouth, too.
Uh-huh.
And my mom could throw shade. You're like, did you just throw shade?
Yes.
Did you just
then do it real
it?
Quick.
Real quick. Right. And it's so natural. Quick and natural.
Don't miss a beat.
Right. Yeah. But I'm like, okay, so, but yes, if you teach your kids the right way to handle conflict and the right way to speak to one another, you know, then I think the world would be a better place because, and it's so sad that this message can't go out to everybody, but you know, some people just raise heathens, you know, for some reason.
That is true.
And then when your heathen get beat up, then you got the heathen mother coming. Now you got to beat the heathen mother up. And now she all big and heathenistic and looking a mess. And you like, no, I'm too cute to fight your heathen looking self. I ain't doing it. Then you got to go get it back. Now you locked up, cute and locked up. So
that ain't a good mix.
It ain't at all. But yes, just be better people. To, like I said, every week I say the same thing. Be better people to one another. And this is not hurting y'all to do that. It don't cost y'all nothing to be nice.
Yes.
It don't cost nothing to say hi. It don't take nothing from you to say hey. Mm-hmm. Nothing. So just be better people to one another, y'all. And that will be our wrap up, I believe, for this segment of Frankly Friends. Take care of each other, love each other, resolve conflicts, and we'll be right back with us.
Life. life comes at us fast. One thing that gives us comfort is knowing that someone is there when you need them. Well, at Pleasant Hills Insurance, that's our promise to our clients. Call 770-910-7460 today or visit our website at PleasantHillsInsurance.com for your free, no-obligations quote on retirement and life insurance. Many of the large agencies have turned their back on the retired workforce. At Pleasant Hills Insurance, if others can't qualify you, very often we can. Pleasant Hills Insurance proudly provides options for preconditions. So call 770-910-7460 or visit PleasantHillsInsurance.com today for your free, no-obligations quote on retirement and life insurance. Pleasant Hills Insurance, we're here when you need us.
You're listening to IBNX. IBNXRadio.com. The station with the
best music.
Best music.
I love the music.
Hey, what's up? It's Jay-Z.
Hey, I'm Mariah Carey.
Hey, it's Katy Perry.
It's your boy T.I.P., man. Get in.
It's your boy Sean Kingston.
What's up, y'all? I'm Beyonce.
This is Nicki Minaj, and I'm in the mix with
IBNX Radio.
We're back with the Hey Shamika Show with comedian Alicia Coley, and another guest just walked in the building. Miss,
hey,
you know what? You a comedian, so you ain't new to this. Let me hear how you introduce yourself, Karen. How you introduce yourself when you coming on somewhere and nobody don't know who you are and all of that stuff? Oh, go wrap it around the outside. You know we live, so we do this. But welcome to the stage. No, go ahead. How you just introduce yourself when you coming on camera? Let me see how you do.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the stage. It is Karen Kennedy.
I did not expect all of that, Karen. Well, all of that voice. She done did that from the diaphragm.
I love that energy. She sounded like an announcer for real.
She did. She's about to play. Let's play ball. She's about to.
I'm saying.
We appreciate you coming out to hang with us this evening.
Well, thank you for having me, ladies. Yes.
It's good to finally meet you. I've been talking off and on trying to get this interview together. And
it takes a week sometimes, child.
Well, it was funny because I kind of dropped the ball, but I felt like it was her, but I didn't want to blame her. When I had the text message, I was like, oh, shoot, that was me. So I couldn't even get out of it and say it was her. You know how you try to blame somebody because you was the one. So, but yes, welcome to the show. Let everybody know what you are up to these days, where you're from, how long you've been doing what you're doing. This is really an informal type of interview, but we want to get the people to know who Miss Karen Kennedy is.
Okay, well, I am new to Atlanta, Georgia, by way of Oakland, California.
Oh, chef. You got the crip walk.
No, that's LA.
Oh, I thought it was all the same.
Uh-uh.
No, okay.
No, Oakland, the Bay Area, San Francisco Bay Area.
Okay.
So I just landed in, I'm another transplant. Sorry, I know that Atlanta is full, but you know. My hips ain't that big. You know what I mean? I won't take up too much space.
It's not wrong with transplants.
Huh?
It's not wrong with transplants.
We all transplants.
Hey, we help make Atlanta.
I'm saying, right.
We all transplants
they like this Cali swag.
They do. And my Philly swag.
Right. A DMV swag.
Right. Exactly. But the traffic out here sucks, boy. That's all it is.
Yes. Mm-hmm. The traffic is a mess. She's going to tell something. Mm-hmm. She be in the back seat chilling. Well, the front seat now. But yeah, so what are you working on these days?
So, I mean, literally right now, I am about to do my first headlining set.
Okay.
And, thank you. In Seattle, Washington.
Okay.
Yeah. So I got 30 minutes.
Nice.
Yes. Congratulations.
Thank you.
You said this is your first time headlining.
This is my first headlining, yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. So I'm super excited about that. And I just jumped into comedy earlier this year.
Good.
Okay. Look, she is firing me right now. She just jumped right in this year.
Really, you know, she is about the headlines.
I was going to say, I jumped in a couple months ago. I'm working on it, though, because she gave me the eye. Y'all at home. On listening on the radio, I ain't see Alicia. She gave me the eye.
She been.
I'm getting it together.
It's been about what, 2 years?
No.
Or a year?
It has not.
That you've been talking about. No. Been talking about it.
That I've been talking about it. Yes, for a year.
And then you took the class.
Yes, in July.
Yes. And now it is September.
Yes.
And you haven't been on stage.
yet.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
But I'm tightening up my.
Let's set a goal. Let's set a goal. What's the goal?
What's the goal?
Yeah. What's the
date?
Yes.
Yeah. I want to get in on that.
So, the goal is to
look,
start doing.
Put you on live. Wait a minute.
To start doing open mics next month.
Okay. Next month, end of the month, or next month, beginning of the month? Because that's broad.
Next month, beginning of the month.
Okay.
Like, we have fall break at the end of September.
Okay.
So I figured that's a nice few days to kind of get in the nice head space to get ready for that. So, beginning of the month.
Ladies and gentlemen, you heard it here first. Shamika said that she is going to get on stage at the beginning of the next month because there is fall break coming up, and she going to have time. So y'all better let her on y'all stages, okay?
Yeah. Now, I ain't saying I'm going to be the best, but I'm going to do my best at that time. And, hey, got to get out there and do it sometime and, you know, get my feet wet and just do a little bit better every time.
Hey, the thing is to start.
Yes.
That's right. The thing.
Right.
Yes.
Yeah.
So, all right. So, you got, I said, what do you do, Karen? And you sent me a whole plethora.
Everything.
Yeah, a whole plethora of how you trying to get... What you trying to get hired for?
Awesome, educator.
Right. But I mean, just call Tyler. You know what I'm saying? Just call him.
Exactly.
Keep that same energy. Tell all right, how so, Tyler so Kelly
talk about
in.
Everything. Talk about the author. Let's talk about the author first.
Okay, so a few years ago.
Okay.
I don't even remember. I jumped in on a couple of book projects. And so one was called Socially Smart and Savvy. Which is also the title of my brand, and a group of us experts just offered a chapter to the book, and it's just everything etiquette, everything savvy, you know, dressing, fashion, wine etiquette, technology, just everything, right? So it's a great book. And then Lisa Nichols, one of my personal mentors, Sandra Yancey, Marsha Weider, and Lisa Sasevich, we all did another book project, and that one went on to become a bestseller in about 11 categories on Amazon. So, you know, so, yeah, so a couple of books, you know, because they say you gotta have a book. So I'm like, okay, get a book or two.
Nothing wrong with being an author.
Yeah.
Writing is therapeutic. I love to write. Very therapeutic.
I like to write too, but you know, it's some of the stuff I write about, I can't be publishing to nobody.
Well, yeah. We're gonna talk about it on your next interview. We'll talk about that.
So let's talk a little bit about being an educator.
So I have an etiquette school for girls called Lady Blossoms, finishing school for girls. And for girls 8 to 18 years old, and I work as an educator to teach girls etiquette, just, you know, how to present themselves, how to think about where they are, where they're going, who they're going to be around, what, how they want people to receive them and to perceive them as well. So we talk about all of those different things. Just everything. And the program is tailored to the specific girls that I teach, whether it's younger girls or the teenage girls, because, you know, we don't have all the girls in one group. And I've also done a program for college age girls as well.
I think that's amazing. Okay. And I think that's definitely awesome. Needed because some girls don't know how to be young ladies.
Yeah.
Yes.
So I think that's very important. And do you do that here in Atlanta now? Mm-hmm. Or okay.
Mm-hmm.
How often?
Whenever anybody call me.
Okay. Now, do you do anything for like actual schools as well? Like do a
So, like earlier this year, I did our second annual dining etiquette.
Okay.
It was a partnership with TAG Academy, Atlanta Public Schools. We did it over at the Four Seasons. All of us got together and had a really nice three-course meal at the Four Seasons.
That's nice. So I'm not eating around you because you're not gonna be like, girl. I'm the heathen. You know what I'm saying?
Be looking like,
yeah, like that is not your salad fork. I'm like, shoot, I was hungry.
how? Too funny.
No, but you know what? People always said it, and I don't even get down like that. You right. know, I let people. What it is about etiquette is just knowing what to do, because so many right. people just will miss opportunities yes. because right. they don't know what to do.
Right.
So when you at home, you do what you do at home, and then when you're around other people where it matters, then yeah. you do those things just so you don't miss the opportunities.
What is one thing that you can tell us that people miss the mark on when they're out eating, that they miss the opportunity? Like, they just sit in there and you look at them, you're like, oh, she forgot the, or he done. Just one thing.
Okay, I'll tell you a story. I went out with okay. a brother.
Okay.
Ooh, and he was talking with food in his mouth and his stuff was coming out of his mouth. I'm like, So there's a mirroring thing that you can do, right? Mm-hmm. So if you start to do something, then somebody else will start to do it mm-hmm. too, right?
Right.
So I just started to stop talking. You know, that STFU. I just, right. you know, right. just shut up.
Right.
And so I'm like, let's just eat. And he just kept talking. And it was a business thing, too. And I was just like.
He's like, you know, Karen, I'll stop, blah, blah.
Right. And so.
It's good being here with you.
Right, right. And so the thing about it is, it's just little stuff like that that can make a big, big difference. I remember I had a client, we Skyped. Mm-hmm. He lived in Texas, and I was in California at the time. And he was native India.
Okay.
Okay. And he was a manager, and he swore that his group was, you know, treating him differently. They weren't inviting him to lunch. And he was just like, I'm looking, I don't know what to do. There's mm-hmm. something that's happening. I was like, well, we talked about so many things, and then I said, well, how are your eating? How are your dining skills? And he was like, oh, they're fine, they're fine. I don't know. Let's right. talk about them. And so he said that he was rushing to eat, you mm-hmm. know, because he wanted to get back to work on time and be a good example. Well, come to find out, he had food all on his shirt, mm-hmm. and he's talking, and yeah. Ooh. So we went over to dining etiquette mm-hmm. via Skype, and he was surprised because that was just the cultural difference. He didn't think that yeah. that mattered right. for men.
Yeah, because and a lot of think that people that mattered from in India, leadership. They eat with their hands yeah. and stuff like that. So
that's true.
Yeah, so I get it. It's very culture shocking when you see something different.
Yep.
So
that's true.
But we were going to wrap up real quick because we got to take a commercial break. But right after the break, we're going to come back with Karen Kennedy. Hey. And ask us some more questions. So we'll be right back with the Hey Shamika Show with comedian Alicia Coley.
You're listening to IBNX. IBNXradio.com. The station with the
best music.
Best music.
I love the music.
Hey, what's up? It's Jay-Z.
Hey, I'm Mariah Carey.
Hey, it's Katy Perry.
It's your boy, T.I.P., man. It is.
It's your boy, Sean Kingston.
What's up, y'all? I'm Beyonce.
This is Nicki Minaj, and I'm in the mix with
IBNX Radio.
Hey, this is My The Voice. You're listening to the Hey Shamika Show with comedian Alicia Coley on the IBNX Radio.
All right, and we are back with the Hey Shamika Show with comedian Alicia Coley, and we still have Karen Kennedy in the building.
Hey, hey.
And this is the part where we talk about comedy and conversations. We have some comedy for you. We have some conversations for you. Or we might wrap it all up into one. So we like to bring in comedians during this segment. Up-and-coming comedians. Comedians that's been on the block for, you know, a couple years. And right now, Karen, if y'all was just tuned in with us, y'all know that Karen is an up-and-coming rising star comedian who just started. She's a female comic, as you can see. She got good skin, too, y'all. I'm about to get in on her. I'm about to get on her skin regimen. Because I don't know if she put baby pee on her face. You know they say put the diaper on your face or something. But, Karen, welcome to the show. And how you doing again?
I'm good. I'm happy to be here.
Good. So you already told us that you have been in Atlanta
just a couple of years.
Yep. And you get ready to start beating up the comedy scene, or you've been on the comedy scene?
I mean, I've been out.
And how's it going?
It's going all right.
Okay.
Yeah, it's going all right. I went up to Chattanooga.
Okay.
I've been out to Jackson. I'm from Jackson.
Okay.
So I did my first feature in Jackson. That was big. I was excited about that. Mike Town in Jackson. Okay. I want to shout him out. Yep, that was awesome. And then just the local places here, mm-hmm. you know, everywhere.
Favorite open mic in Atlanta?
Uptown.
Okay.
Yep.
Okay. And now, is your stage name your Karen Kennedy?
Karen Kennedy.
Okay, because like I said, board. This is my first time meeting her, and she's right. a comedian, so I've never seen her. She's never seen me before. You know I'll be out. Uptown is a pretty decent club.
I had a good night there.
Good.
Yeah.
Good. Was anybody there that you met in particular that kind of piqued your interest as far as the comedy scene or?
No, I've met a lot of comedians.
Okay.
I've met a lot of comedians. Okay. So, yeah.
All right. Well, tell us about your stand-up a little bit. What do you talk about when you go on stage? And don't give us no punchlines. They got to pay for that.
Right.
But tell us what's your angle when you talk about when you're on stage.
Girl, I'm talking about this dating, this single life.
Okay. That's, yeah, relationships.
You know, that's funny as hell.
Yes. Yes.
Relationships. There's a whole lot of material right there.
Yes, it is. And so relationships is one.
Mm-hmm.
And it, like you said, there's a lot of material. What else?
That's it.
Okay.
That's it.
Just relationships?
Just being single all that encompasses. So I'm talking about, you know, girlfriends and their experiences. Mm-hmm. I'm talking about online dating. I'm talking about
everything.
Everybody. Okay. Yeah. Is this a PG?
Well, now that the kids are here, it's a little PG-ish right now.
Okay. Yeah.
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 Well, you know, she's a mom, so I assume she would know.
It was funny because I thought after a while she was like, "Oh, wait a minute."
Right.
Okay. Yeah. All right. Yeah.
We got kids. Even though they know how they got here, we just want to still keep it PG.
Right.
So, what else? So you said I want to talk about your headlining date that you have, because you said it's where again?
It's in Seattle, Washington.
And who do you already do? Do they pick the openers for you, or you tell them who you want to open the show? Because, you know, as a headliner, you kind of get that authority to be like, I don't want him on, I want her on.
No. So it's a private event.
Okay.
And so I am the entertainer for tonight.
Okay.
So there's going to be a band, live band, and they're going to be performing and stuff. And then they go, have Karen Kennedy.
Now, you live band, do you sing a little?
No.
Okay.
That's a separate act.
She's like, that's more money. You got to pay
me
right. for that.
That's extra. Right, to act the fool.
I'm saying if you can sing, you kind of work that into the deal.
No.
I'm working on that piece of my set. I'm trying to bring some singing into it. Because I miss my calling. Like, I was supposed to be a singer. I had a girl group when I was little and all of that stuff, and it just didn't work out. So now I'm living my singing life through my child.
Okay.
And I'm going to just stay with these jokes.
Okay.
You know, and actually, we have a little show tomorrow in Snellville, so if you ain't doing nothing tomorrow, come on through. Snellville.
Okay.
And the flyer is on my page. Don't ask me the address. I'm just going to be there.
Just Google it.
Come on over. But definitely.
Now, you were saying that you just jumped into the comedy scene this year.
Yeah.
So, I mean, you were talking about this year, like January, March. What's this year?
April.
April. Okay,
April, now. And now it's okay. I'm excited to see you because like
that's quick.
It takes a long time sometimes for people to just jump out there and be like, I'm headlining.
Well, okay, so here's the other thing. I'm a professional speaker as well. So I'm comfortable on stage. I've done some acting. In fact, I just picked up a role here. Mary, what is it called?
I don't know.
Mary.
Marietta?
Marietta Theater in the Square.
Gotcha.
Okay. Yep. Okay. Yep. Yeah, so I just, And I did some stage acting in California.
Good.
So nice. I'm comfortable and familiar with the stage. And so comedy was just, it was just an extension of that. Yeah.
Now, has comedy always been something that you were interested in, that you had a love for? Or how did you come across wanting to do comedy?
Because the comedian was like, Karen, you funny. You ever thought about that? You ever thought about comedy?
And was that Sanchez?
Huh?
Was that Sanchez?
It wasn't. No. It was another one. But I was just like, okay.
I'm going to try it.
And so I'm just a yes.
Yeah.
You know, for performing in the arts and theater and, you know, and all of that. And then, you know what I do with comedy?
What's that?
I just pretend that I'm an actor who's whose role is a comedian. That's right. So I just, so it's kind of me doing both at the same time. Mm-hmm. And then I'm not like emotionally attached to it.
Right.
And I just look at my comedy book, you know, my joke book as my script. I just get up there and say it. And so then like the audience, whether they're, you know, because sometimes when we at the clubs and stuff, you know, they be doing other stuff.
Listen, last night had a lot of other stuff.
Right.
Let me tell you, last night, let me come off my live and tell you about last night. So I was there.
I need to get off my live.
No, you can stay on your live. But I just wanted to get off my live real quick.
Gotcha.
But I was at a comedy spot last night, and I'm not going to go too far in the story, but another comedian, I won't name no names either.
Okay.
So another comedian had a room.
Okay.
And it was at a hole in the wall, but not hole in the wall that we do on Mondays. But it was at a hole in the wall. It looked like an old Piggly Wiggly that they shut down, tried to build back up, threw some wood around the frame, and just was like, okay, we doing comedy here. So it was about 25 old people in the building. They weren't that old, but they weren't that young. But it was late for them to be out, but they wanted some chicken wings and tacos.
Okay.
So I'm following this guy, right? Not that he's a funny comedian.
Okay.
But because the environment was not typically an environment where he was accepted, he didn't do so well. So he was like, that's my time. So they was like, oh, okay, next coming to the stage, Alicia Coley, right? So I'm going to the stage. The DJ messed up my music.
Oh,
so you either gonna play it or you not gonna play it is my thing.
Okay,
because I don't necessarily need music to go and do some jokes. I can do that without. So you either gonna play it or you not. But when I start talking, don't play it. So I said, "Oh, you messing up," but I didn't use mess up.
Okay,
I said you messing up. So he was like, "Oh, you ain't gonna come in here and call me a mess up."
Oh,
well, sir, I didn't call you a mess up. I said that's
you're
what you
not gonna do. Right?
Yeah, you. That's what
you're not gonna do.
So he was
today,
like, well, blah, blah, blah. So we going back and forth, and I'm about to start my jokes because I'm like, I'm going to ignore him because he's fat and miserable. I'm going to ignore him looking like Jabba the Hutt back here like he on the table. just a miserable man.
Yeah.
So I am getting ready to start my jokes, and he cuts my mic off. I was like, so now I'm yelling, did you just cut my mic off? I don't need no mic. I can tell these jokes.
Where'd she say she came on? What's funny is
I can see her doing this.
But then the thing is, I was like, you know what? This is an open mic. I'm not even getting paid. Take this mic and I'm out of here. The whole comedy show got shut down last night. It wasn't my fault.
Wow.
It was the DJ's fault. I'm not taking the blame. So we will move on to the next open mic location. So
yeah, so I mean, open mic, that's a whole different type of interaction, if you will. You know what I mean? Because any other time, you know, the audience is there, you have their full attention, and then they came to see
when
you
they pay for the ticket.
When they pay for the ticket, that's why I said that my, you know, Uptown, because I was there, and it's a comedy club, and you have a stage, and you're elevated, and people are, you know, front and center, and the seats are facing the stage, just,
you know, the whole logistics of it all. So,
yeah,
I do well there. I did well there, and I've done well, and I've had some good nights and some bad nights.
You know how it goes. Guess what? You got some more bad nights to come and some good nights to come.
Oh, yeah.
But how can we stay in touch with you, Karen, and find out what you're doing and where you are, social media, next date, what you're doing?
Okay, so on Instagram, you can follow me at Socially Smart and Savvy.
With two Vs.
That's correct. Mm-hmm. Yeah. So it's SOCIALLY, Socially Smart and Savvy. And then also Facebook, Karen Kennedy, Socially Smart and Savvy, sociallysmartandsavvy.com. You know, it's Socially
she
Smart.
She got it ready.
You D, just, all of
ready
the
to go.
You just right. Google me.
Just Google me. I'm Googleable. So with that said, we will be right back with the Hey Shamika Show with comedian Alicia Coley. We got Sean McKnight in the building, and so don't go nowhere, y'all. Be right back.
Hey, you're listening to Hey Shamika with comedian Alicia Coley on IBNX Radio.
Pimp gang with my pinky ring. Lot of gang, lot of in the icy chain. While you claim that you rich, that's a false claim. I be straight to the whip, no baggage claim. Whole lot of styles, can't even pronounce the name. You ain't got no style, see you on my Instagram. I be rocking it like it's fresh out the pan. Only when I'm taking pics, I'm the middleman. Walk talking like a boss, I just lift a hand. 3 million cash, call me Rain Man. Money like a shower, that's my rain dance. And we all in black, like it's gangland. Say the wrong words, you be hangman. Why me stick to you like a spray tan? Mister, what kind of car you in? In the city, love my name. Gotta say it. She can get a taste. She can get a taste. What did you say? It's all the same like Mary Kate. She can get a taste. Let you get a taste. D let it taste, yeah that's cool, but he ain't like me. A lot of girls like me, like wanna fight me. Get your check like check Nike. Me not icy, that's unlikely. And she gon' shoot me like a icy. Chains on the neck for the whole team. And I feel like Gucci with the ice cream. And my bitch with the Fenty, not the Maybelline. I'm the black JB, the way these bitch green. Make this bitch green. Pretty little thing. Like my AE. Say, yeah, that I mean. She can get a taste. She can get a taste. What a nigga say? It's all the same like Mary Kate. She can get a taste. Let you get a taste. Do you love the taste? Yeah, that's cool.
Yeah, I'ma put the drip on the plate. Yeah, diamond ice glaze. Imitate, hey, feed me grapes, maybe with the Drake. Slow pace in the rave, got the from base. Diamonds at the par, the kicker hitting hard. The Robert's in par, I'm at it on Mars. Shotgun shells, we gon' always hit the target. Popcorn, bitch, shell popping out the cartridge. 3400 outside, char bar. 4-8-8 Ferrari. Make her get on top of me and rob me like a heart. She wanna keep me company and never want to bar. No department, yeah. Fish tail in the parking lot. I don't kick it with these. They talk about you, yeah. And I got the fight, don't make me spark it at you, yeah. Keep it in my back pocket like it's a wallet. Got the way she suck it like a jelly. Stack it up and put up with the whole project. And she got that paddock on water moccasins. I'm rich in real life, I get that profit copy.
Taste, she can get a taste. Let you get a taste. Do you love the taste? Yeah, that's cool, but he ain't like me. LA, you can get a taste. Miami, you can get a taste. Oakland, you can get a taste. New York, do you love a taste? Chi-town, you can get a taste. Houston, you can get a taste. Portland, you can get a taste. Overseas, let them taste. She can get a taste. She can get a taste. Do you love a taste? Worldwide, they gon' get a taste.
We
are back with the Hey Shamika Show with comedian
Alicia Coley.
And we have our next guest with us, Sion Knight, a.k.a. DJ Caution. How are you?
I'm doing good.
You doing good?
Yes, ma'am.
We're glad to have you here. Oh, look at him, so polite. Yes, ma'am. I love that. So I met you, it's been a few months ago now, but I met you at a event that they had here in Atlanta.
Silence the Shame.
Silence the Shame, that's right, which was a good event. And I noticed there was some good music. I was in there. I was dancing around. And then I look over, and I see.
There's a baby on the one and two.
I said, wait a minute. I said, is he the DJ? They're like, yeah. I said, oh. So I went over and talked to him. I said, we need a DJ event at our school. Mm-hmm. You know, can you DJ for us? He's like, sure. That's my mom information. So talk with his mom for our love. You know. Unfortunately, didn't get the event DJ, didn't work out, but kept you in mind. Mm-hmm. So we wanted you to come on tonight, talk to us about how it is to be a DJ and be a teenager at the same time. So you go to Cobb County Schools, correct?
Yes, ma'am. All
right, so how's school?
I'm doing good, keeping up with my grades and DJing at the same time.
Okay, so how old were you when you started DJing?
8 years old.
8 years old? Okay.
Yes, ma'am.
All right. Who is your favorite DJ?
It will probably be DJ Khaled.
Okay. Why? Why DJ Khaled?
DJ Khaled!
Why?
I always wanted to do that.
Why Khaled? That's too easy. That's like when I asked her favorite thing, she's like, Beyonce, why DJ Khaled?
Because he's a role model, and he doesn't just do what he does because of the show. He does it because he knows he's doing, and
because he loves it, right?
Yeah.
Yeah. So and you love what you do.
Yeah, okay. Definitely.
How much do you love it?
A lot.
Like, what would you do if somebody took it away from you right now? You can't DJ no more, Sion. What would happen right now with your life?
I would be mad. It would probably be, I don't know.
Would you
That's
cry?
That's a good question.
Nobody never asked you that before?
No, not really.
And you know why? Let me tell you why that thought just crossed my mind. Because if this is your passion and somebody took it away from you, you got to figure out, like, what is keeping you doing this DJing? Like, what makes you know that you are DJ Caution? Like, what makes you get up in the morning and say, I'm about to spin these records, or I'm about to get on this Apple computer? You got an Apple computer?
No, ma'am.
What
PC.
You use?
PC. Dell.
Okay, well, that's
PC,
cool, too.
That's what's up.
Listen, when I do this Dell PC, I'm about to wreck shop, and they about to take this from me. No, y'all not going to do that because this is my passion. So just find that, you know, always find that, like, thing that keeps you going and keeps on lighting that fire in you to do that DJ thing. Like, I don't really know much about DJ, and I just know I dance to the music. So if you a good DJ, we talking about you.
Right.
You know? So just make sure you keep on doing what you're doing now. What's next for you? What you got any events planned?
Not this month, but maybe next month. The beginning of, yeah.
Okay. What are you doing?
Maybe I think a birthday party.
Okay. Nice. Now, I heard that you did some proms last season?
I did a Sweet 16 like a week ago.
Oh, nice. Shucks.
Now how was that?
It was good. It turned out to be great.
Now, how old are you?
14.
Wow. 14 at a Sweet 16.
Oh, buddy.
Like, excuse me, can y'all get off my booth? I'm only 14. My mom is right there. I'm only 14.
Well, do you have a lot of friends at school that ask you to do events for them?
Yes, but they don't want to pay me, so I don't accept it.
That's right.
Yeah. That's right. You
get that money.
Get that mind on you right, boy. He's starting out right.
Yeah, it's no problem doing stuff for friends, but yes, they definitely need to pay you for your talents.
Cause they would pay DJ Khaled.
That's right.
That's right.
He didn't become DJ Khaled doing it for free.
Okay.
No,
you don't want to be DJ
cheap.
For free.
Mm-hmm. Right.
Now,
don't be giving out no good discounts.
Since you DJ, do you do other stuff with music? Like, are you in band or chorus or anything in school?
Yeah, I do play the snare.
Okay, nice.
Yeah. Can you explain to me what that is? I'm a little ignorant.
It's a type of drum that you play with drumsticks.
That's right. I forgot.
Right. I haven't now, heard is that the like one of the ones like when you'd be like in drumline?
Yeah.
Gotcha.
Nice.
So how long have you been playing the snare?
3 years now, going on 4.
Okay, oh, so nice. You like that too. Yeah. Any sports?
Yeah, basketball.
Okay.
Wow.
Well, watch your fingers, okay? Because you need that to DJ.
Yeah, you're right.
I like
you gotta
that.
Get money on both
well
sides.
Well-rounded. Like that. Sports, music.
Love it. Mm-hmm. So what is your favorite type of music to play when you're DJing?
It would probably be hip hop. Maybe because, I don't know, I guess I listen to more hip hop, so I'm more used to the songs. So I know how to manage it, mm-hmm. other than country, like I don't know nothing about.
Well, listen, you're going to have to learn about all genres because there's money in all genres of music. And I know your mom told you that because she looked like she's smart over there. I know. Dad, I'm going to give you some credit too, Dad. But,
reggae music too.
Okay.
Nice.
Okay, good.
Now, have you come to the point where you have mixed a little bit of, you know, the newer hip hop with some old school hip hop?
Yeah, my
or
dad.
Or some older R&B?
Me and my dad working on that. I got
nice.
It.
Okay. Yeah, you definitely need that, especially if you're going to do some, not proms, but like some more birthday parties where then maybe not be teenagers, you know, maybe somebody's in 20s.
Your dad age.
Yeah. You know.
Yeah, old.
You know, type of oh, he's doing a 40th birthday party? Oh, yes. You definitely work on that playlist with dad now.
Yep. Yeah, so who's your favorite you old ready. School artist that you like to play that your dad has showed you, like, you got to play this one or you got to do this, and you're like, yo, I'm feeling this, dad. Who?
MC Hammer.
Okay.
What?
Hammer was getting it. Hammer was getting it.
You know what? It's crazy. I thought I was going to be a dancer for Hammer one day. I did. I had Hammer pants and everything. I did. And I was can't touch this all day. All day long, but it didn't work out. So I'm here at the Haitian Mika Show, which is a great thing. But have you listened to Biggie Smalls' music or Tupac?
Yeah, Tupac, definitely.
Okay. All right.
And is there an old school DJ that you would like? I know DJ Khaled is your favorite. Are there any old school DJs that you kind of like their style of DJing?
Not that I know of.
Nothing. Okay. All right. You might run into a few as you start DJing a little bit more.
Yeah.
I'm one of people, I kind of like DJ Jazzy Jeff.
Oh, yeah.
From DJ Jazzy Jeff.
You got to talk about Jazzy Jeff.
Yeah. You know DJ Jazzy Jeff? Okay.
No.
Well, you know Will Smith, right?
Yes.
Okay. So Fresh Prince had his own DJ, DJ mm-hmm. Jazzy Jeff, and they did a lot of records together. So mm-hmm. as you get into your music and stuff, you'll probably listen to it. You may like a little bit of their stuff, but they had a lot of hits coming up.
And I don't know what type of DJ you're going to turn out to be, but when I say that, I'm thinking positive. But only thing, please play a little bit more of the record than what they play now when we go to the club. Because you'll be into the song. I'm like,
right.
Hey, that's my song. You're like, they just changed it. I'm like, yo, I was just two-stepping like a mug on here, like, and now it's gone. So, you know, just pay attention to the crowd. Because you got to know your crowd. With any talent you have, if you're a comedian, if you're a singer, you're a DJ or whatever, you have to know your crowd and what they're partying to. Because you never want to be a DJ and the whole floor get clear. You want people on the dance floor all the time listening to your stuff. So just mm-hmm. make sure that you're not so much into the music as
the crowd is.
You want the crowd into the music more than you, but you want to be just listening and honing in on, like, hey, okay, they like this. Okay, then what's the next one? I'm going to get them. I'm going to kill them with this one. I'm going to kill them. They ain't even ready. But, yeah, I think it's amazing doing what you're doing. How is it when you go to the parties? Who your bodyguard?
My dad.
Mom said me. Said, damn, mom said me.
Dad seemed kind of calm, but he looked like he could really get on somebody if he had to.
Dad is real calm. I think he used to be a killer back in the day. I'm going to stop messing with Dad.
He used to DJ also.
Oh, nice. Okay, runs in the family.
That's mm-hmm. cool.
Love that.
That's cool. And I think, you know, as children, parents, or even whoever is guiding you mm-hmm. should show you, be able to show you some things that they used to do or show you another way to make money, because we are so, and I don't know what your path is. So I just want to make sure I say this correctly, that it's not always about corporate America and making your money from corporate America because a lot of times black people have those hidden inner talents where we can make money doing pretty much anything.
Mm-hmm.
So just make sure that, you know, if you have to go the corporate America route, that's fine. You know, but try to always have a side hustle. So if that's DJing, if it's, I know how to do this electric real quick, or I know how to program a computer, or I know how to go and play some drums because they need this real quick on the band. Like, you can just do a little bit of everything. So just don't, and don't be so focused in on just one thing. You know, wear different hats. Don't make people put you in a box and say, no, I can't do this because it's going to make me go this route, or I can't do this because it's going to, you know, just explore all options. And while you got parents that care, a lot of people don't have that. You got two parents that are here with you, that care about you, that want to make sure that you're on the right path. Just make sure that you tell your parents how much you appreciate them, because there's so many parents that's out here, they don't even know what their kids look like. You know, so just keep on doing what you're doing. Do you got an Instagram page? You got a Facebook page?
Yes, MusicMaster113.
MusicMaster113. And is it spelled just like you saying it?
Yes, ma'am.
MusicMaster113. Yes. Okay, awesome. So you said your next event is a birthday party. Is that the 40th birthday party?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, and you ready for that?
Yes, ma'am.
All right, you sure?
Still preparing, still practicing, but at the end of the day, I will be ready.
Because, you know, older people, they could be a little rude. They were like, boy, play something else. You know, they could be a little rude sometimes. You're like, look, ma'am, I got you. What you want to hear? Like, matter of fact, my name is DJ No Request. But no, I think that's amazing what you're doing. Anything else we got questions for?
If you had any advice that you could give to another teenager that's out there, or even someone that's in grade school right now that's thinking about going into music or becoming a DJ, what advice would you give them?
Whatever your passion is, just don't stop, because you may never know where it will take you.
Awesome. That love that.
So much short.
I love it. Well, see, that's why we have the adolescents.
But I need real quick, because you said you like DJ Khaled, and you know he loud. So I know when you spinning them records, when you got a microphone, you don't be talking like this in the microphone, do you? Mm-hmm. What you be doing? Let's real quick.
Yeah, give us a little bit.
What I do?
Yeah, because you want people to know who you are, right? Mm-hmm. They come in the door, they got a DJ, the DJ popping. Like, yo, who the DJ? And you be like, yo, this is Music McMaster, C.I. Knight, blah. How you do it? I don't know. I want to hear how you do it.
So maybe at the beginning, I'm starting to let people know that I have an Instagram so I could gain more followers.
Absolutely.
And then at the end, just ask how they felt about me so I could maybe next time do better.
Okay, but before all of that, though, I want to hear how you deliver your who you are in a microphone. Like, your mom, she might say, oh, this is my baby. But you don't want to be the baby DJ. You want to be DJ Caution. So when you on the microphone and the people coming in, they want to know who the DJ, how you announce yourself. Let me hear.
I said, it's DJ Caution, and you're tuned in to the live mix.
Okay.
That's right. Hey. Awesome.
That's amazing. I'm really proud of you. I think, you know, us, and this is my daughter, like she says, she's a singer or whatever, and she's an aspiring singer. It's just so important for us to really support our children. And because these DJs, they about to die soon. We need new DJs. Singers, they going to die soon. We need new singers. So just make sure you keep on doing what you're doing. And I appreciate that.
Definitely will. Yeah,
anything else you want to say? Tell the people.
Any shout outs for anybody?
Any shout outs?
Shout out my parents.
Oh, listen to that.
They always there.
Love it.
That's not going to get you more on your allowance. That you still have to clean your room tomorrow when you come home from school.
Well, thank you so much for being with us tonight, C.I. We appreciate it. And hopefully we'll get to see you DJing something soon, okay?
Okay, hopefully.
All right. And this is Hey Shamika Show with comedian
Alicia Coley.
We'll be right back, guys.
Yes, we will.
Life comes at us fast. One thing that gives us comfort is knowing that someone is there when you need them. Well, at Pleasant Hills Insurance, that's our promise to our clients. Call 770-910-7460 today or visit our website at PleasantHillsInsurance.com for your free, no-obligations quote on retirement and life insurance. Many of the large agencies have turned their back on the retired workforce. At Pleasant Hills Insurance, if others can't qualify you, very often we can. Pleasant Hills Insurance proudly provides options for preconditions. So call 770-910-7460 or visit PleasantHillsInsurance.com today for your free, no-obligations quote on retirement and life insurance. Pleasant Hills Insurance. We're here when you need us.
This is Sion Knight, aka DJ Caution, and you're listening to the Hey Shamika with comedian Alicia Coley on IBNX Radio.
we're back on the Hey Shamika Show with comedian
Alicia Cooley.
And of course, that was Whitney singing, y'all. So y'all know this is Shamika Says. Just a little bit of inspiration and motivation to get you guys going through the week. This week, I just want to talk real quickly about making sure that you're doing something for yourself. I know Alicia talked about it before, that you have to, as much as you put out for other people, you need to make sure that you're putting back into yourself. You need to make sure you're filling your cup, filling your bucket, whatever metaphor you want to use for that. You need to make sure you're doing something for yourself, guys. Every day, every week, every month, so on and so on. So whether that be meditation, exercise, if you like to write, sing, watch TV, whichever you want to do. But I would, even with the watching TV, if you're into entertainment and you're watching TV from the aspect of studying something, I would say yes to do that. It's okay to relax a little bit and watch TV, but when I say do stuff for yourself, you want to do stuff that's personal development.
Right.
Is where we're going at. So something that's going to feed your soul,
feed your mind. Wallet.
Yeah.
Feed your wallet.
Yes, feed your wallet. Stuff that's going to, personal development, that's going to help motivate you and inspire you to keep going along your journey, whatever that journey may be for you. Yes. Now, while we have everyone here in the studio, we're also going to go around the room and everyone's going to talk about what they like to do personally, stuff for personal development, anything that helps motivate you and inspire you to keep going. So, Miss Amaya, we're going to start with you.
So, what I like to do when I'm home, I dance around, I hook my phone up to my speaker, play loud music, practice what I'm supposed to be doing for my singing lessons. Sometimes I just write down music and all that.
So when you say write down music, so do you like write down music as far as writing songs? You do a little songwriting? Oh, no, it sounds like you're doing it. Okay, you gotta start somewhere.
She's basically saying that her teacher is just not just teaching her lessons. Her teacher is teaching her from an actual book to learn, like, what the notes mean and what the pauses are and how to break up the music notes.
Right.
So she'll give her that, you music know, take theory. This home and do your homework, because you ain't just going to learn how to sing. You're going to know how to be a singer, ma'am. And tell them, this is the key I need, you know, to put this in. So when I sing, you ain't going to make me look stupid.
I love that. I remember them days.
Yeah.
Woo.
Yeah.
That's a good thing to have, though, because not everybody gets to have that aspect of it.
Exactly.
And like you said, it's important, especially if you're doing it as a career, to be able to know. You just don't want someone to tell you,
right,
this is how it should be. You'd be like, yeah, that sounds good, but
right,
I think that da-da-da, and you can tell them,
exactly,
no, it's going to sound better in this key, this spacing, what have you. So awesome. Miss Alicia, what do you do for your personal development, ma'am?
So I do a lot of things for personal development, but first let me just say this, because Shamika did quote me, but it was like a sub quote, but I just want to bring it to where my verbalization comes in.
Yes, ma'am.
No, basically, I always say this because I know that I pour into a lot of people, you know, because I think I have a gift of like counseling, and I have a gift of just helping. And sometimes I hate that I have that, you know, because sometimes it can take so much away from you physically. It can take so much away from you emotionally, and you have to have a way to get that pouring back into you. So when you pour so much out, you need something or someone to pour back into you, because if you're not, your cup is emptying, and right, then you don't have any more gas. Right. And you need that. You need something to bring that back. So for me, one of the things that I know for me, me and my husband, we talk, you know, so he'll pour back into me what I already poured out to somebody else. Or it could be a friend, my mom, my sister, just my kids, anything. So what I also do is I write, because I know these jokes ain't going to just spectacularly appear.
Right.
I mean, they can, but it's going to fold in the middle of the set. So I got to make sure that I'm writing. So I'm sitting there writing, and that's the way I grow. And I pray on that. I pray, you know, God, please make me the funniest female comic ever, and let them not be ready for these jokes that I'm about to deliver, because I need that. I need this money, because I'm not trying to work in corporate America for the rest of my life. I don't want to do that, even though the money is great. I need greater money. You know what I'm saying? So I know that that's what I want to do for myself, and I do want to get back into acting. I might want to get back into singing, you know, but for sure, always be your best, be the best that you can be. Don't think for a second that a mentor may not be necessary because you don't have all the answers. It's okay to ask. And I'm going to end it with that because I got so much more, but I'm just shut up.
All right. Ms. Karen?
Oh, I'm a gym junkie.
Okay.
So I just like to...
That explains your skin.
Even though I've been off my regimen here lately, okay, I think this is like thick Karen right now. But I like to swim. I like to run. I like to work out. I just like to hike and just be outdoors in nature.
So that's what you do for your personal development. You go to the gym and...
Yeah.
Yeah. Awesome. Yeah. I need to do that.
Yeah.
Body's in motion.
Yeah.
Get awesome. This body in motion.
Yep.
All right. Sion, aka DJ Caution.
I like to, we could say, skate. I like skatering, and if I'm not doing that, then I'm practicing DJing, making sure my laptop is up to date for my next gig.
Awesome. We don't need no viruses. Make sure that thing is on point.
For myself, like Alicia said, we a lot alike, but you Pisces, I'm Aquarius, so that happens. We get along. But I also do a lot of things for personal development, but every day I do meditate. When I get up in the morning, I just have a quiet time where, you know, I pray, you know, I may read some type of, you know, positive quote or affirmation and that as well. I also write. Writing is very therapeutic for me. I'm actually writing a book. Woo! Right now, and been writing some songs, so we'll see how that turns out here in a little bit. But and I also sing. I love to sing. I love music. I've always loved music. I've always loved to sing, and to me, it's just very uplifting for the soul and for the spirit, and just to get in that happy place. But I'm happy a lot of the time.
Favorite song, real quick.
Somewhere Over the Rainbow.
For real?
Yeah.
Girl, you are so Broadway. That's awesome.
Well, you already know my favorite movie is The Wizard of Oz.
Oh, yeah.
So
the white
it's from,
one.
Yes.
Yes. Okay. Yes. Mine is
the Wizard of Oz.
Mine is just The Wiz.
Yeah.
Okay.
I know The Wiz one of my favorites, too. But no, that's just from, you know, that's just the main movie I remember from 3 years old.
Okay.
So, Amaya, I'm with you on the 3 years old.
Right.
You know, it's stuff that I've, you know, loved since three. And actually, for children in general, people that are listening out there, most children they can remember from three on.
Yeah.
So that's why a lot of kids, when they're getting into different languages, when they're getting into different art forms, that's where it starts. Mm-hmm. So definitely at that age, if you see them starting to taking a liking to something, just kind of help mold them into that, encourage them and that. And everyone that's listening out there, make sure that you're doing your own personal development, like I said, whether it be meditation, you know, praying, writing, reading, any of that. Just make sure you're doing that. And make sure you're also helping to spread inspiration, motivation, and positivity to other people.
That's right.
This is a big thing for Hey Shamika. This is one of the big reasons why I started Hey Shamika, to help, you know, spread positivity in the world and to help others be inspired and be motivated to continue on their purposes in life, their journeys. And even though it seems like everyone is disconnected at times, we are really all connected, guys. You know, everything happens for a reason. We all kind of piece together along our journeys. Sometimes it's a short period of time, sometimes it's a very long time, but you want to make sure you're taking care of those that are around you, because they will help take care of you in the long run.
They better.
And that's all I got this week for Shamika Says. Anybody have anything they want to say, inspiration, motivation wise?
Nope. Let's get this money. Let's get this money. It's too much out here. Let's get this money.
All right. So we're going to give a chance for everybody again to say how people can reach them on social media. I don't think we gave you a chance earlier, Maya. So if you make sure to let people know how they can reach you on social media, ma'am.
So I have an Instagram page. It's called My The Voice, M-A-I, The Voice. So.
All
right. And she has a Facebook page. It's Amaya Coley. No, it's My Coley, M-A-I Coley, C-O-L-E-Y. So Alicia Coley is my name. You can reach me by that on all social media sites. It's A-L-I-S-H-A, Twitter, Facebook, Instagram. Oh, actually, my new Instagram is Alicia Is Dope. I had to do that because I wanted to make sure that I'm building my followers, man. Okay. Like, my followers is going crazy right now.
When'd you change that?
Oh, I didn't tell you. I'll tell you later. But It's just so that I can make sure that, like, my personal people that I really want to make sure I'm paying attention to, I see their statuses or stuff. Like, it's so my other page is still up and running. It's not going anywhere. But because I'm building that up, I want to be more, you know, focused on that one. So, Alicia is dope because I is. All
right.
So, are you Karen Kennedy?
Karen Kennedy, you can find me social media, Facebook, Instagram, Snapchat, Twitter, all of that. Now, you can find a page. You might not find me there. On IG, definitely, you can just search me, Karen Kennedy, and you'll find me at Socially Smart and Savvy.
Okay. Awesome. All right. You can find me on Instagram at MusicMaster113. Facebook is the same thing. Find me on Snapchat at DJCaution_4Life.
Awesome. And I'm simply Shamika Love on all social media except for Twitter. Twitter a little different. So it's Shamika Love 24/7, 247.
Okay.
But that's Shamekalove. Hey Shamika is on all those as well, HeyShamika. And then for the show, guys, I always have to point this out, is Hey Shamika Show, HeyShamikaShow. I'm sorry I have so many different ones, but I have my own page, I have the Hey Shamika brand, and then I have the show, so gotta kind of separate them there. But we appreciate you guys listening every week. We appreciate all the support. Keep listening in. Keep tuning in. Tell somebody else. Everybody, I'm tasking y'all with this right now because I haven't said this before. Everyone, every week, tell two other people.
Oh, there you go.
About the Hey Shamika Show. So if you do that every week, we're going to get two more and two more and two more.
All right.
And two more.
All right. So, again, appreciate all your guests coming out. You guys are awesome.
Yeah, thank you,
and
guys.
And until next week, this is Hey Shamika Show with comedian
Alicia Coley. Y'all go and be great now.
IBNXRadio.com.